I think the pleasing thing was it was a convincing win. Scotland obviously talked up their chances of beating England and beating the old enemy, which quite rightly so. I mean, that's, you know, that they haven't come here to just to make up the numbers and enjoy a World Cup. They've come here to show they're a good side, and they've got a lot of very good players. And we were really pleased with our performance, you know. And I thought the Scotland team showed some real glimpses of good quality, but it was about us yesterday, and we needed that performance, we needed that result, and it was great that we only had 2 days between games from playing New Zealand to playing Scotland. So, I think the timing of it worked really well for us. The great thing was that Belly's actually had a massive influence on Moeen with his bowling last year. He spent a lot of time working with him, talking to him about the pace to bowl, the lines to bowl in Test cricket, and players learn from players, and Belly, with all his experience and knowledge, has been a great person for Mo to learn from. He enjoys batting with him. I mean, Mo started his career at Warwickshire, so he knows Belly very well, and I thought the two of them complemented one another fantastically well yesterday. You know, had we been 20 for 2 on a damp wicket, it was a tacky wicket, it wasn't an ideal toss to lose, but that the boys came through that really well and then went on to show their real class. And I thought you saw two very different innings. You saw an innings of someone who was watchful, careful, cautious, supported the other player, and we didn't need both players playing big shots, but I thought Moeen played exceptionally well. I reckon that's probably as good of innings as I've seen him play for England. It would be up there with the Test 100 he got at Headingley when he had to bat all day. I thought that the way that he played, the way he constructed his innings, the way he went about it, and it was no surprise having seen the way that he'd practiced for the previous few days. But to be fair, all the guys have practiced really well. So yesterday's performance was a good one. But we now, you know, our attention turns very quickly to the next game, which is Sri Lanka on Sunday. We've all acknowledged that he's someone who's grown very quickly over the past year. He's learned very quickly. His practice ethic is outstanding. He's a student of the game, and he's one that everybody wants to see him do well. That's players and staff. So, you know, the fact that when we went to Sri Lanka for the series there and he got a big score in the first game, that sort of said to the rest of the lads, it's okay to go and play that way. And he plays that way, and we want him to play that way. And, there's a lot being said about, you know, we're not sure about how we want to play. We know who we want to play. But the first two games, we didn't play well enough. We definitely know we want to play. We want to be positive. We don't want to be reckless. And there is a difference between being reckless and being positive. And we want to play positive cricket. Moeen epitomises the way that we want to play. But other people, their skills are slightly different. They go about the job in a different way. And Ian Bell in the last 26 one-day internationals prior to this last game, his strike rate was something like 98.99. He scores at a decent rate without whacking the ball to all parts, but he's an accomplished player, he's a world-class player, and he accumulates his runs. He might not hit lots of sixes, but he plays proper cricket shots for his boundaries for fours. So, you know, I think those two complement one another. It was no surprise they played as well as they did. And it was great that we went on and got 300 and played really well. You know, we were fortunate that we only had 2 days between New Zealand and Scotland because we needed to play again very quickly. But having got the win, and today, you know, the lads are very happy to make the journey from Christchurch back to Wellington, where we were last week, back to surroundings we know very well. Day off tomorrow, there's a few playing golf, and then which will be nice, and then we head into 3 good days of practice, and they'll be well structured, as they have been all trip. And what we want at the end of it is to convert the good practice into another very good performance on the field for the team. And, you know, we know we're capable of that. The lads know they're capable of that. As I say, there's some really high quality cricketers in the team, and they'll be keen to put on a show and show everybody how good a team they are.